I'll say, hi everybody. It's good morning here in Helsinki, so good morning. And yeah, that means I have made it to Helsinki, which is a huge leap because outside it's fall. There are beautiful yellow leaves all over the lawn outside, but of course I was in Hong Kong sort of today, it feels like yesterday, where fall was the farthest thing from anyone's mind. It was quite hot and muggy. So I have loaded up my body with all of my winter clothes to get here from the airport. Thanks to the North Face, though, for not managing to get me my winter jacket. Yeah, the North Face had 2 months to get my winter jacket to this house where I'm staying, and they have failed. So I'm going to make sure I give them lots of PR for that until they solve the problem and get me my winter jacket. But enough about me. Let's do some yoga. So I've just come off a 10-hour transatlantic flight. So for class today, I'm planning to do some things to open up my body to help all of us open up our body. Whether you've been flying or not, it's always nice to start at the bottom and work our way up and just really find some space and some clarity for our body, for our mind, so that things can move and flow the way that they have evolved to do. I don't usually use props for these classes, but for this class I'm going to ask that you have an extra yoga mat handy if it's possible. If it's not possible, you can use a blanket rolled up or a towel rolled up. And you don't need an extra yoga mat if you have your yoga mat. You can also just use that and roll it up when it's time, which it will be time soon. So yeah, that means calf smashing is coming up, folks. So get ready for that. All right. Thanks for being here. Thanks everybody who's tuning in. It's nice to have you here. Hey Steve, what's up? All the way from Mui Ne, Vietnam. Xin chào. Take a comfortable seat, everybody. Let's begin. My plan is to do about a 55-minute practice from now. We'll see what happens. Thanks for being here. Sit up tall and close your eyes. Breathe through your nose. My focus today is going to be our breath. Breathe through your nose and notice your breath. You don't have to change it. You may have already changed it, and that's fine. Just keep it where it is and notice your breath. And bring a little focus into your breath. Work to make your inhale and exhale slightly longer. Just deepen your breath. And think about the very bottom of your torso, the bottom of your pelvis, that part of you that's sitting on the ground. And tone those muscles slightly. Sometimes called Mula Bandha in yoga. Tone your pelvic floor. I'm not doing a big lesson on this today, so if you don't know how, I'll give you short instruction. Move your sit bones towards each other, so those bony bits at the bottom of your hips. And then, so those are the sides of your pelvis. Think about the front and back as well. So the front of your pelvis or your pubic bone, and the back of your pelvis or way down at the bottom of your tailbone. Move your pubic bone, the front, and your tailbone, the back, towards each other as well. So that muscle, those muscles at the bottom of your pelvis slightly engage. Work to have your inhale and exhale the same length as each other. And tone your pelvic floor, Mula Bandha. Partly that's to help create stability in your deep core, for stability for your whole body. But also it's part of the the reminder of Ujjayi Pranayama, which we're building up to. Ujjayi has lots of little things built into it that are there to help us remember if we are doing Ujjayi or not. Tone your pelvic floor being one of them. When you notice it's not toned, you're losing a part of the Ujjayi, so bring it back. I think of each of these as like tying a string around your finger, but here it's tying a string around your pelvic floor. Just like we work to make our inhale and exhale the same length as each other. And when that's not happening, it's another string around a finger to remind you. Breath, steady, consistent. There are two other pieces of Ujjayi that I want you to focus on today. Think about your belly. It can help to touch your belly. Work to keep your belly steady or close to steady as you breathe in and out. So rather than letting your belly move a lot with your breath, work to engage the muscles in your abdomen to steady your breath, to steady your belly. This is shorthand for what we call Uddiyana Bandha, or the upward rising lock. Again, it's helping engage another aspect of your deep core to support your torso, to support your back, to support your whole body as you move. Tone your pelvic floor. Move your sit bones towards each other, pubic bone and tailbone towards each other, and engage very slightly at the bottom of your pelvis. Steady your belly so that it's not moving out or in dramatically with your breath. It can move some. Have your inhale and exhale the same length as each other, and have your breath steady throughout the whole inhale and the whole exhale. Then the last piece that we'll work on is toning your throat. So work to engage at the back of your throat like you are trying to yawn, but then you're hiding the yawn. Or engage the sides of your throat so that the muscles tone slightly there, so you start to be able to hear your breath as you inhale and exhale. We'll put those pieces together. For today, we're going to call that Ujjayi Pranayama. There's always more we can do on any of the things we work on. For today, we'll make these four barriers be our barriers for Ujjayi. And when one of them is missing, and you notice it's missing, it's just a reminder to come back. No judgment, just come back. Tone your pelvic floor. Engage your Mula Bandha. Tone your belly. Draw in and slightly up. Uddiyana Bandha. Work to have your inhale and exhale steady and consistent for the whole inhale, the whole exhale, and make them the same length as each other. Engage at the back of your mouth, in the sides of your throat, so that you can hear your breath slightly. Ujjayi Pranayama. Floor, draw your belly in slightly, steady your breath, tone your throat. When you're tired, Ujjayi is the perfect thing to help you wake up slightly. By controlling your breath in this way, not only are you activating your deep core, which is going to help stabilize everything, and when you're tired, that's essential, but it's also regulating your breath so that you can extract more oxygen from each breath, so that you can feed your brain more, feed your body more oxygen, to wake it up. With your next inhale, bring your hands to Anjali Mudra. Let's sing one om together. Exhale fully. Tone your pelvic floor, Mula Bandha. Draw your belly in and up, Uddiyana Bandha. Inhale fully. One om. Bow your chin to your heart. Lower your hands to your lap. With an inhale, lift your chin. Make your way into Balasana, child's pose. Take your knees wide. Place your feet flat, sit on your heels, and stretch your arms out. Balasana. Straighten your arms so that you can lift your elbows off the ground, spread your fingers, and spread your toes. Come to your breath. Move your sit bones towards each other very slightly, and move your pubic bone and tailbone towards each other very slightly. Tone your pelvic floor. If you don't think that you can move your sit bones towards each other or your pubic bone and tailbone towards each other, try it. We're not talking about a really big movement, it's a much more subtle engagement of muscle. And then tone your belly. Slightly draw your belly in and up towards your head so that you might even feel a little more length in your spine here. You can adjust where your head is on the mat if all of a sudden you need to create more space. Work to make your inhale the same length as your exhale. Tone your throat so there's a slight sound to your breath. Take your left hand and place it on your right hand. Don't move your head or your upper body. Take your right hand out from underneath your left hand and move it over about 2 feet, unless the bed's in the way, which I'm finding, so I'm like reaching my hand underneath the mattress. Then stretch with your hands. Straighten your arms. Stretch to your left side. It's not a big stretch. It's just a subtle stretch. Push with your left hand. Stretch back with your left hip and get a stretch through your ribs. Tone your pelvic floor, Mula Bandha. Tone your belly, Uddiyana Bandha. Steady your breath and tone your throat, Ujjayi Pranayama. Spread your toes and push your toes down. Then walk your hands back to the starting position to arms straight. Take your right hand and place it on your left hand so that your right hand is pushing into your outer edge of your head. Then take your left hand out and underneath, move it over to the left about 2 feet. Don't move your head or your upper body. Push with your right hand, stretch back through your right hip, push down through your toes. Parsvabhasana, side, child's pose. Stretch through your right side. Notice your breath and work to keep your breath steady. Work to make your breath even from beginning to end. Spread your toes, push your toes down, and walk your hands back to center. You need to adjust slightly to center yourself in child's pose. Do that. Lift your forehead off the ground very slightly. Stretch your spine. Bring your forehead back down. Place your right hand behind your head. Push down with your right arm. Push down with your left arm. Roll to your left a little and lift your elbow up. So lift your right elbow up. You can always
screen to see what I'm doing, perhaps. Lift through your right elbow. Push down with your right, your left arm. Then come back to center. Stretch your right arm out. Bend your left elbow. Place your hand on the back of your head. Push down with your right arm. And roll to the right a little bit. Lift your right, your left elbow up. Push down with your right hand. Lift your left elbow higher. Come back to center, child's pose. Up to your hands and knees, tabletop, or all fours. Place your hands flat. Bring your shoulders over your wrists so your arms are straight up and down. Make your wrists parallel to the top of your mat. Have your knees about hip distance apart, just a slight bit behind your hips. Exhale fully and push down through your hands. On your pelvic floor, draw your belly in, and inhale, round your back. Cat. Stretch, stay here with your exhale, push through your hands, and really round through your upper back. Tuck your tailbone underneath you, draw your belly in. Inhale here. With your exhale, move to cow. Arch your back, look up, move your pelvis back. Move your shoulders away from your ears. Inhale here. Lengthen through your ribs. Move your hips back as you exhale. And with your inhale, lift your chest up more. And move into cat. Exhale. Round your back. Cow. Inhale. Cat, exhale. Cow, inhale. Cow, sorry, cat, exhale. All playing jet lag. Inhale. Cow. And come to neutral. Tuck your toes under like you are about to do downward facing dog, but you're not about to do downward facing dogs. Tuck your toes like you are though. Lift your knees just a bit and then really get your toes pushed down into the mat. Then bring your knees back down to the mat, but stretch them back towards your feet as you do. So your toes get really tight, so the fronts of your shins are tight. Then walk your hands back, sit on your heels, and sit up tall. And if some of your toes have come untucked, reach back and tuck them under. And then sit up tall. Toe crusher. That's what I generally call this. A toe smasher. Super like awakening pose for your feet. For your toes. The fascia at the bottom of your feet. Feels really nice after having been sitting in an airplane for 10 hours. Of course, nice is relative, right? It doesn't necessarily feel nice. Yoga helps us differentiate between the feelings of sensation pain and danger pain. This is just sensation pain. If you're starting to lean forward, back so you can sit on your heels. 50 seconds more. Steady your breath. Practice your Ujjayi so it will see you through. Tone your pelvic floor. Focus on something else. Tone your belly. Steady your breath. 5 seconds more. sing the Hallelujah chorus here if it helps. Place your feet flat. Sit on your heels. Stretch your toes out. So push your toes down. Stretch them out. Sit up tall. Vajrasana. Tone your pelvic floor. Engage your Mula Bandha. Tone your belly in and up slightly. Engage your Uddiyana Bandha. Engage the sides of your throat and breathe Ujjayi Pranayama. If you have a second mat that you can use, now is the time for it. If you are on a yoga mat and don't have a second yoga mat, totally normal, that's fine. Just roll up the mat that you have. And if you have no mat, you can use some things you might have around, like a towel, roll it up tight. You can use a pillow, but like this pillow is too soft, it's not going to do any good. The good news for me is that there is a Manduka mat here that I can use, so it's a, I think it's a Manduka Pro by the feel of it, so it's going to be pretty thick and strong. We're going to do what I call calf smashing. So we did the toe crushing or toe smashing, so this is calf smashing. I'll turn around so you can see what I'm doing a little more. Take the roll, so either your mat, your spare mat, or a towel, and place it behind your knees as tight as you can, and then sit on it. So just like that might have made you feel something in your toes, this is going to make you feel something in your calves and the muscles of your lower legs, which is what we're hoping to do. We're hoping to open up and stretch your calves. Stretching the muscle of the calf muscles and stretching the tissue, the fascia that holds them all together. It's going to make your legs feel so much better at the end of this. Even though right now it might not feel like this is like helping, it might feel like it's hurting, it'll wake you up, it'll open up your legs so that you can keep walking today. Do whatever your day is going to bring for you. Tone your pelvic floor, engage your Mula Bandha. Steady your belly, draw your navel in and up slightly, engage your Uddiyana Bandha. Tone the sides and back of your throat to engage your throat, to hear your breath, to remind you to keep it steady, to keep working, Ujjayi. Undo the roll by a quarter turn. So lift your hips up, turn it a quarter, so not much, and then sit back down. We're going to work down our calves in four stages. So this is the halfway mark. Push down through your feet, push down through your toes, and sit up tall. If sitting like this is hurting the front of your ankles, you can always place something under the front of your ankles, like another towel there to lift them. Especially with men, it can hurt to sit like this with your feet flat at the front of your ankles on the ground, because we're not used to walking with our toes pointed. We're not used to work. Most men not used to walking around in high heels. More common with women. It's general. Don't get offended if you don't fit into that. I'm just generalizing so that I can help some people out here. So if the front of your ankles are sore, it's normal. A lot of things that we do in yoga open our bodies up in ways that we don't regularly in our daily life. Okay, let's do one more quarter turn closer towards your ankles. If you do wear heels regularly, you're probably starting to feel a bit of pain now. Since I don't wear heels regularly, the pain for me is at the top of my calf. But my experience says that when people generally wear heels, that the pain in this calf smashing happens more at the bottom of the calf, where the calf and the Achilles tendon meet. So just breathe through it. Spread your toes, sit up tall, tone your pelvic floor, tone your throat.
So now you should be at the Achilles or at the back of your ankle. And sit up tall. Move your sit bones towards each other. Move your pubic bone and tailbone towards each other. Just enough to tone the muscles at the bottom of your pelvis. Mula Bandha. And move your ass, those bony bits at the front of your hips, in towards each other slightly. Move your ribs in towards each other slightly to tone your belly. Just to tone, though, not to flex a lot. Draw your belly in and up slightly. Uddiyana Bandha. Engage the sides of your throat. Tone your breath. Make your inhale, exhale, same length as each other. Ujjayi Pranayama. You might want to keep your blanket or mat handy for this next one. We're going to move into Virasana. So if you can sit on the floor between your heels and Virasana, do that. But if it helps to have your hips elevated, and helps means you actually can't touch the ground in Virasana without support, then you can use the mat or a blanket or a block to lift your hips up. I'll turn around again so that you get a better visual of what we're talking about here. So move the roll from behind your legs, separate your feet just wider than your hips, and sit on the ground between your heels. If sitting on the ground isn't possible, you can lift the ground up by placing a mat underneath your hips, or a block is a little better if you've got a yoga block, or you can use a cushion. Just because we have official yoga props doesn't mean that if you're not using them, you're doing something wrong. They're just there as tools to help us. And if we don't have them, if we can't afford them, totally fine. Just use what you've got. Light on yoga makes a really good prop. Mr. Anger would fully appreciate that. Push down through your toes. Move your sit bones towards each other. Move your pubic bone and tailbone towards each other and sit up taller. Draw your belly in and slightly up. Uddiyana Bandha. Tone your throat. Steady your breath. Walk your hands back behind your feet, and lean back on your hands. Push down through your toes, lift your hips up. I really like these hip lifts as a way to stretch the fronts of my legs, stretch my quads. So push down through your toes, stretch your knees forward, and that's going to help a lot. They won't really move, but actively engage with your mind, your muscles, to stretch your knees forward, tighten up your butt, and lift your hips. Push through your toes, push through your hands, and then lower your hips down. And exhale. Inhale, lift your hips up. Exhale, bring them down. Inhale, lift your hips up. Exhale, bring them down. On this next one, we're going to hold it. Inhale, lift your hips up. Push through your toes, stretch your knees forward. Stretch your tailbone forward so that it feels like you're tucking your butt underneath you. And you should start to feel that stretch the fronts of your legs. Lower your hips. Sit up for your asana. Spread your toes. Push your toes down. Palakasana. Plank pose. Walk your hands forward. Stretch your legs back. Tuck your toes. Bring your shoulders over your wrists. Push through your toes, push through your hands, and straighten your legs from your knees. There'll be sensation there because they've been bent and folded for a while, but that sensation is just all the fluids moving and waking up the joint. Bend your knees, down dog, bend knees. Lift up through your shoulders slightly, and stretch up through your pelvis, through your tailbone. Again, here, move your sit bones towards each other slightly, move your pubic bone and tailbone towards each other slightly, and then lift that up towards the ceiling. Draw your belly in. Lift that towards your head. Tone your throat.
Make your inhale the same length as your exhale. Ujjayi pranayama. Use that to wake your whole body up. Stretch it out. Speaking of stretching it out, if you're okay with knees bent and you don't want to go further, stay here. But if you want to take it a little bit further, stretch back with your heels to straighten your legs. Or to not change the shape of the rest of your body, but from your knees down, straighten your legs by stretching your heels back. So work to keep your back straight and strong, your arms engaged, and your pelvis lifting up. And tone your Mula Bandha, tone your Uddiyana Bandha. Ujjayi. Lift your heels, bend your knees, look forward, and walk to the top of your mat. Separate your feet about hip distance apart, make them parallel to each other. Fold forward, touch the ground. Touch with at least all of your fingertips. But if you can do legs straight and have your hands flat, that's fine. Do that. Uttanasana. Push down through your feet. Push down through your hands. Lift through the fronts of your legs and lift through the backs of your legs. And stretch your head down. Uttanasana. Intense pose. Place your hands on your hips, lift your elbows up, and stand up. Oh, we're actually going to get to stand up in this class.
I know. I'm going to stand back a bit so you can see me. Look at your feet and make your feet hip distance apart, parallel to each other. Spread your toes. Stretch your arms out at your sides. Tadasana, mountain pose. Your sit bones towards each other. Move your pubic bone and tailbone towards each other. So the very bottom of your pelvis is getting a slight toning. Mula Bandha. Think about your hips, the very front of your hips, which are technically your pelvis, but that's a conversation for another day. Those little bony bits we sometimes call your hip points, move them slightly towards each other. Knit your ribs in slightly towards each other so there's a toning underneath your six-pack. The muscle there. The muscle, the six-pack muscle, rectus abdominis. We're trying to engage the transverse abdominis, which is a deeper layer of muscles. And it goes sideways, so that's the toning of your belly. Engage your throat. Steady your breath. Stretch your arms up, Urdhva Hastasana. Inhale. Fold forward, touch the ground. Uttanasana. If you need to bend your knees to touch the ground, bend your knees. Ardha Uttanasana. Straighten your arms. Lift your chest. Stretch your spine. Stay here and exhale. Stretch your tailbone back. Stretch the top of your head forward. Inhale. Look down and exhale. Move your shoulders away from your ears. Inhale, stretch long through your spine. Fold forward, Uttanasana. Ardha Uttanasana, straighten your arms, lift your chest, look through the top of your head, not through your eyes. Stretch forward through the top of your head. Then exhale, fold forward. Ardha Uttanasana, inhale. Step back to plank pose, palakasana. Exhale. Inhale, push through your hands, push through your toes, draw your belly in. Exhale, Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha. Tone your throat, inhale. Chaturanga Dandasana. Exhale, point your elbows back, push through your hands. Bring your shoulders as high as your elbows and hold, inhale. Draw your belly in. Exhale. Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha. Inhale. Steady your throat. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Inhale.
Adho Mukha Svanasana. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Bend your knees.
Come forward. Float or walk to the top of your mat. Ardha Uttanasana. Inhale. Uttanasana. Exhale. Urdhva Hastasana. Inhale, and lose me a little in the camera, and I might run into the chandelier. Tadasana, exhale. Urdhva Hastasana, inhale. Uttanasana, exhale. Ardha Uttanasana, inhale. Make your way to Chaturanganasana, exhale. Up dog, inhale, and then we're going to hold here for your exhale. Push through your hands, push through your feet. Inhale, lift your chest up. Lift through the top of your head. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Tone your pelvic floor. Tone your belly. Engage your throat. Inhale. Ujjayi. Downward facing dog. Exhale.
All of that work. Ujjayi. Inhale. Stretch through your shoulders and exhale. Lift your pelvis up, stretch your heels down, inhale. Exhale. Last breath here, inhale. And exhale. Bend your knees, flip forward, float or walk.
Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana.
Urdhva Hastasana, inhale, Tadasana, exhale. One more, Surya A, inhale up,
exhale, fold.
Engage your Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, inhale.
Make your way to Chaturanganasana, exhale. Up dog, inhale, down dog.
Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Tone your pelvic floor. Draw your belly. Lift your hips up. Inhale. Exhale. Make your arms straight and strong. Bend your knees. Look forward. Float or walk.
Inhale. Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Urdhva Hastasana. Inhale. Tadasana. Exhale.
Bend your knees. Lower your hips. Sit down. Stretch your legs up. Give your legs a little shake. Oh, I'm just gonna look over and see who's... Maurizio is in the UK following along. Hey Maurizio. Namaste. That's so cool. I hope you're enjoying England. So glad that you're here for class today. That's awesome. Stretch your legs out. Give them a little shake. So we're going to do just a little bit of back bending to do some of the opposite actions. We've been doing a lot of forward folding work. And so now I'll do a little bit of back bending because we opened our thighs up and now we can open up our chest and our spine a little bit more. And that'll be about all we have time for. So come onto your belly.
Place your feet flat, roughly sit bone distance apart, and straighten your ankles back behind you. Place your hands like you're going to do cobra, but we're going to do something a little different. Push down with your pubic bone, push down with the tops of your legs, push down with your feet.
Lift your hands off the ground. Lift your head and chest off the ground. So I call this flying cobra. It's one of the variations that we can do of Bhujangasana, cobra pose, to really help us learn how to push down and use our back to lift our chest up. So push down with your hips, push down with your feet, use your back muscles, especially into your upper back, to lift your chest. Don't forget your ujjayi. Move your sit bones and pubic bone, tailbone in. Draw your belly in slightly. Tone your throat. Bring your hands to the ground. Without moving your hands, pull back energetically. Lift your chest up more. Bhujangasana. Point your elbows back. Move your shoulders down. Lift your upper back up. Keep your gaze forward or just lift your chin very slightly. Lift through the top of your head. Lower down. Stretch your arms back at your sides, turn your head to one side, and rest for just a moment. Rest, but steady your ujjayi. Practice all that work here. Tongue your pelvic floor, Mula Bandha. Your belly in and up slightly, Uddiyana Bandha. Tongue your throat, and use this pause to reset. Turn your head back to center. Bend your knees, grab the tops of your feet. So reach back with your hands, hold the outside of your feet, but hold the tops of your feet. I like to touch my thumbs to the outside of my ankle bone. You can probably see that on the camera if you want to see what I'm talking about. So my fingers wrap around the inside edge of my arch of my foot, and my thumbs are touching the outer ankle. I just find that gives me some nice stability in my hands. Push your pubic bone down. This will make your knees come up slightly, and that's okay. Lift your shoulders away from the ground, then use the weight of your body pushed down, lift your feet up, kick your head up. So kick back with your hand. That's what I mean by kick your head back. Kick your feet back to lift your chest up. Then pick your feet up higher, kick back a little more. Dhanurasana, bow pose. Push down through your hips, lift your upper chest, lift your feet. Slowly lower down. Turn your head to one side, and I really like this. Rock your hips a little bit from left to right, right to left. Just find that can be really freeing for your sacrum or lower back after a back bend. We want to make sure that we're putting our back bend into more than our lower back, but that doesn't mean that our lower back doesn't take a lot of the work of the back bend. So it's nice to just give it a little more love. And the Uddiyana Bandha is really going to help protect your lower back. It's part of what it does. Turn your head back to center. We'll do one more Dhanurasana, bow pose. Bend your knees, point your toes. You can have a choice here. You can grab the tops of your feet, or if you want to go a little bit deeper in the pose, grab your ankles. Push down through your hips, lift your chest, lift your shoulders, use your hands, pick your feet up. Kick your head back by kicking back with your feet. It's going to move your head from forward to back. So don't throw your head back so your throat closes. Just use the power of your legs and the tension of the work in your arms. Tone your pelvic floor. Tone your belly. Lift your feet higher. Dhanurasana. Slowly lower down. To transition, come into child's pose. transition over onto our back momentarily.
But taking rest here in child's pose, it's not really a rest. It's more of a chance to bring your lower back into slight flexion, slight rounding. Because it's the most mobile part of your back, and when we do back bends, it takes a lot of force there in the pressure between the vertebrae into the discs, and so it's nice to just give them a little bit of love here. But just a little bit. Sit up.
Swing your legs around the front and lie down on your back again. Just have to adjust the computer here because it's gone to sleep. Lie down. Bend your knees and place your feet on the ground. We're going to do a bridge pose. Septi Bandha Sarvangasana. Have your heels about hip distance apart, near your hips so that you can brush your fingertips to your heels. Push your feet down, bend your elbows. Push down with your feet, lift your hips up. Lift your elbows off the ground momentarily. Push with your shoulders and lift your upper back. Then interlace your hands underneath you, tuck your shoulders in. Push down through your shoulders. Push down through your feet to lift your hips higher. And don't forget your Ujjayi. It's going to be really useful to keep you steady, but it's also going to help keep your lower back safe here. So turn your pelvic floor, move your sit bones in, move your pubic bone and tailbone in. Steady your breath so that you can probably see your belly here while you breathe. Work to keep it steady. It's going to help create a pocket of air to support your lower back. Work to make your inhale and exhale the same length as each other. Tone your throat. Ujjayi. Without moving your feet, pull back with your feet so that your legs engage more, so your hamstrings engage more. Then unclasp your hands, lower your hips down. Don't bring your knees into your chest, stretch your legs out straight, or keep your knees bent, feet on the ground. Steady your breath. And bend your knees, place your feet on the ground. Set your feet up for Septi Bandha Sarvangasana again. Bend your elbows. Let's try that again. Lift your elbows off the ground. Same thing we did the first time. Push down through your feet. Lift your hips up. Use your upper back to lift your chest. So you can push with your shoulders and lift your upper chest, but your elbows are off the ground, so you're having to use your muscles a little more. Then interlace your fingers underneath you again. Tuck your shoulders in. Push your feet down. Push your shoulders down. Lift your hips up. And practice your Ujjayi Pranayama. Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha. Tone your throat. Steady your breath. Pull back with your feet slightly so your hamstrings engage more. And then stay here. Or place your hands underneath your shoulders. Like we were going to do Urdhva Dhanurasana, but you're not going to do Urdhva Dhanurasana. You're just doing this stage. Place your hands under your shoulders. So your thumbs are sort of lined up at the top of your shoulders. Tendency might be here for your elbows to go wide. So instead, hug your elbows in and point them up towards the ceiling as best as you can. But then push your elbows down from the ground, or from the ceiling, so your shoulders push down. Push your feet down, lift your hips up. This is it. So you're either in bridge pose or just hands under your shoulders. Hug your elbows in if your hands are under your shoulders. Push your elbows down into the ground so your shoulders push down. Remove your hands. Or release the clasp of your hands and lower your hips down. Stretch your legs out straight. Steady your breath. Return to your Ujjayi if you've lost it, or come to it and use that as a reminder to steady, find control, find focus. One more bridge pose. This time you'll have the option of Urdhva Dhanurasana. Bend your knees, place your feet on the ground. Bend your elbows. Push your feet down, shoulders down, lift your hips up. Interlace your fingers underneath you, tuck your shoulders in. Setu Bandha, Sarvangasana. Push down with your feet, lift your hips higher. Engage your Uddiyana Bandha, engage your Mula Bandha, so that your pelvis, so that your torso are staying connected. You can stay here in bridge pose, or place your hands under your shoulders like some of us did on that last round. Hug your elbows in if you're going there, push your elbows down. Come to the top of your head, so push through your hands and feet, lift your shoulders, extend your neck, and then come down to the top of your head. Hug your elbows in. Move your elbows towards your feet and move your chest towards the top of your mat. Push through your hands to press up. Hug your knees in. Pull back with your feet. Lift your hips higher. Push through your hands. Urdhva Dhanurasana. If you need to come out of bridge pose, just release your hands and lower your hips. If you're in Urdhva Dhanurasana, push through your hands. Push through your feet. Move your chest towards the back of your mat. Tuck your chin. Bend your elbows, come down to the back of your head, lower your hips, stretch your legs out straight, stretch your arms at your sides. We'll all meet in Supta Tadasana. It's like Tadasana, but on your back. Straighten your legs, straighten your arms, flex your feet, push your shoulders in. Tone your pelvic floor, Mula Bandha. Tone your belly, Uddiyana Bandha. Tone your throat, steady your breath. Ujjayi Pranayama. Bring your knees into your chest. Wrap your arms around your legs. Lift your head and shoulders. Drive yourself into a little ball. You can rock back and forth if that feels good. You can rock from side to side a little if that feels good. Before we finish, we're going to do a twist. Keep your left knee in towards your chest. Straighten your right leg out. Bring your right leg to the ground, bring your head and shoulders to the ground, and then hold your left knee with your right hand, place your left hand on the ground, and roll. Roll onto your right hip, out onto your right foot. Then undo the twist enough that you can bring your left shoulder into contact with the mat again. Keep that. And redo the twist. I find that the most effective way to get the benefit of this twist is to keep your left shoulder on the ground. It doesn't matter then if your left knee comes to the ground. Right? We just want to do the twist in the spine. So push down through your left shoulder, stretch through the left side of your body, and then remember your hip point, or your ASIS at the front of your left hip, stretch that towards your right foot. So like you're trying to actually move the outer edge of your left hip onto your right foot. It's really far away. Let's get a long stretch through the side of your body. Hari Vritta Supta Bhagavastasana variation. Come back to center. Bring both knees into your chest. Give yourself a little hug. Rock from side to side if that felt good before. Rock back and forwards or do little circles. And then keep your right knee into your chest. Stretch your left leg out straight. Place your left heel on the ground. Place your head and shoulders on the ground. Hold your right knee with your left hand. Place your right hand on the ground. Work to keep your right shoulder on the ground this time since you know that's coming. And twist to the left, roll onto your outer left hip, outer edge of your left foot. Doesn't matter if your right knee comes to the ground. I want some opening for your vertebrae rather than your knee to the ground. So keep your right shoulder down. Push it down. Lengthen through the right side of your body and think about the top of your right hip or your ASIS. And from there, stretch that all the way towards your left foot. So you're creating a lot of length and space in the right side of your body. Steady your breath. center. Stretch both legs out. Supta Tanasana. Here in Supta Tanasana, legs straight, arms straight. Over the next couple of rounds of breath, relax your breath. Prepare for Shavasana. And then come into Shavasana. Separate your feet. Relax your feet. Hit your legs. Let them turn out. Turn your palms up at your sides. Relax your fingers and toes. Relax your arms and legs. Relax your eyes so they get heavier in your head. And take a few rounds of breath. Let go of your ujjayi. I like a couple of longer, slower breaths to clear my focus on my breath. Relax your pelvic floor. Relax your belly. Relax your throat. Just rest here for a few minutes.
Deepen your breath. Move your fingers and toes. Deepen your breath. Stretch your belly. Stretch your lungs, fill your lungs with breath to expand your chest and to move even more oxygen through your body to really wake up. Stretch your elbows, stretch your knees. If you like to stretch your arms up and overhead, do that. Roll your ankles and wrists a few times in each direction. Gently roll to your right side and pause there.
with your lower body heavy. Use your upper body to press yourself up. Come to a seated position with your eyes closed. Bring your hands to Anjali Mudra. Finding something to focus your energy on can help in all sorts of situations. It can help if you're at the doctor giving blood. Focus on your breath, don't focus on the needle. It can help you if you're traveling and there are people around you slowing you down. That's how we see it, right? Everything's about us. They're probably also just traveling and trying to get where they're going, so take a breath. Focus on that. In a few hours, I know my jet lag is going to hit, and I'll need to focus on my breath and find something to distract me from the jet lag so that I can stay up as long as I can to help me get over it as quickly as I can. Friday night, I start teaching. When we practice yoga, Ujjayi is there to help us stay focused, to not be distracted by the work or by what's going on outside our yoga mat. Go of your breath and just breathe. Let's end as we began with one Om. Exhale. Thanks for practicing. Namaste. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for tuning in today. Facebook has changed some of their features now. I've been able to create an Adventure Yoga weekly tune-up event that covers several weeks. So that's pretty exciting. So now the Facebook event for this class is also the Facebook event for this class every week between now and the middle of December. So you've all been invited, and it will hopefully remind you next week that class is coming up. And next week I'll be teaching either from the airport in Helsinki or when I get to Sheffield later that day. I haven't quite decided yet what schedule will be, so we'll see. Oh, look at that. Jane decided to join class from Cambodia. That's so awesome. Thanks, Jane. That means we had at least Steve from Moine, Jane in Cambodia, and Maurizio in Northampton, UK. So that's pretty nice. And we've got more people now online, but that's everyone that's commented. Jane and Maurizio used to live next to each other in Los Angeles, now practicing yoga with me from Helsinki in two other parts of the world. I love this. Thanks, everybody. I will give you a little tour here of where I am. I closed the blinds so that I wasn't totally backlit, but you can see out the blinds a little bit. It really is, I'll move over to this one, really is fall here in Helsinki. It's not quite winter yet, so I'm not that annoyed with the North Face, but I am going to comment on this post and tag them in it, and hopefully they'll like get their act together and get me some winter clothes soon. Just take you a little walk through the house to show you where I'm going to be eating breakfast and cooking, making my coffee and cooking some meals. And then I think we can even, it's not winter here yet, because I'm about to go out onto the balcony and I'm just wearing my yoga clothes. So it is cold. Don't get me wrong. I've just walked outside and it is chilly. This is the beautiful yard for Mikko and Katja's apartment. I'm so lucky to get to stay here. Thanks, Mikko and Katja. Really, really nice. Okay, well, that's it. I'm going off to the sauna this afternoon to hopefully sweat this jet lag out of my body. And I'll see you either in class this weekend on Yogaia. I'm teaching live, yogaia.com, Y-O-G-A-I-A. I'm teaching some live workshops this weekend, and I'm teaching some workshops in person at Studio Thule Yoga. So, oh, and Jane says a massive rainstorm has just started in Cambodia, so wherever you are, if it's not raining, you can take comfort in the fact that it's not raining where you are. Nice thing about tropical rainstorms is that they end pretty quickly after they begin. So, yeah, I'll leave you with this beautiful shot of the yellow leaves on the lawn here in Helsinki. See you soon. Thanks, everybody. Namaste.